It's 8,000 kilometres long, weighs around 10 million tonnes, and is currently floating around the Atlantic Ocean.
You're going to need a bigger boat.
Well, not exactly. Because what we're actually talking about is the Sargassum Seaweed Belt, a floating mass of seaweed that stretches twice the width of Australia, turning the Atlantic Ocean brown and emitting a foul odour. And right now, it's so big it's visible from space. First spotted in 2011, the seaweed belt is actually made up of thousands of individual strands, and it's growing, with fears it'll ruin the tourism industries in America and the Caribbean.
Imagine you have a meter-high raft of sargassum piling up on the beach. It smells really bad, so it starts to break down, and it really doesn't create a good atmosphere for tourism at all.
You can't get in the water there. It's not an enjoyable experience.
The giant belt blocks out sunlight, killing ocean life underneath it. And that's not all.
It can create dead zones on top of coral reefs or seagrass, and it can cause barriers so that nesting sea turtles can't actually reach the ocean.
But it does have some redeeming qualities, providing a vital ecosystem for species like loggerhead sea turtles and mahi-mahi fish. Plus, it's a lean, mean climate change busting machine.
Some seaweed is actually what we call a carbon sink, and we really need to find these ways to take carbon out of the atmosphere and stop climate change. There's been excitement about the floating sargassum as actually doing that.
Ironic, really, given climate change is believed to have contributed to the formation of the seaweed mass in the first place.
We're increasing the nutrients going into the Atlantic Ocean, which is essentially fertilizing this really large area. Of course, changing currents and climate change are also probably contributing to this.
So perhaps the solution to sargassum might actually just be more sargassum.
I feel like sargassum is a very contradictory thing, right? Because at once it's the habitat for sea turtles to thrive so that they can go on to procreate, but then they procreate and then the turtles get killed by the sargassum.
It's the problem and the solution.
Yeah.
Which makes it difficult. But so there are some quite exciting things that they might be able to do with it. They may be able to use it as animal feed. They could turn it into fuel or construction materials.
But doesn't it contain arsenic?
It does contain some arsenic, which may be a problem.
Contradiction, okay, yeah.
So to use it as feed or fertiliser is potentially dangerous as it makes its way up the food chain.
When you see the graphic of just how expansive it is, and we use that great graphic where it was like the smell, you could like see it. I could see all our audience members was like, because it's just, you look at that and then you're like, oh my gosh, this is massive. And I had no idea about it.
I don't know how to feel about it. Is it a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, I think you should keep your booking on your Caribbean cruise ship. Just maybe take a wetsuit.